This push that looks intense as fuck.
It's kind of like camping. Intense.
Welcome to another video.
Come on.
Alright, what is good, guys? Welcome back to another video. We're going camping today because this workout's gonna be intense, right? It's day two of the reverse diet, and that's what we're going all into today, is reverse dieting, right? The post-show recovery. What does it look like, right? And I want you guys to apply what you learned today, not only into your future competition prep or even your current reverse diet, but even into lifestyle dieting in general. I'm gonna tell you guys how to transition out of a dieting phase. But first things first, we're gonna have an intense freaking push day. This is gonna be the juiciest pump that I've been able to get in the past several weeks of my life. And it's probably gonna be the hardest workout as well, but you know, I'm up about 4.5 pounds from show day. And that means that I can start busting my fucking balls in the gym again. I don't feel as fragile anymore, right? So we're gonna crush this shit, we'll put sets and reps across the screen, and we'll get right into it. I sound like a teapot.
What is this for?
Gonna get a rig shit. Nick the trainer here. Alright guys, so here's the deal. We are gonna focus on our strength curvature of incline press. Because what happens is you're a lot weaker at the bottom, right? We're a lot stronger at the top. So what this is gonna do is we're gonna be able to load the bar heavier overall, giving us a better response from our central nervous system, obviously. And at the bottom is gonna be the lightest part of the weight, not by much, but just enough for us to be able to get that movement up to our stronger part, and then it's the lightest at the top. So if you look, we go down, the band is pulling, and then as we come up, it's starting to have movement. So it's the heaviest at the top, it's the lightest at the bottom. So we can load some pretty heavy fucking weight here and just really get a response and grow those titties, god damn it. That's where you need to be for chest. I said we got this in the bag. Money, Em. That needs money. Push, damn it. Oh, you fuck.
I'm a bitch just to roll. just actors, there's a Washington ball. I'ma play this out song on a small side man. Murder niggas in my scrap bin. Maybe we can get along, maybe we can be friends in another looking like my friend.
What's going on, guys? We got me and Jerry. Let's not show your butthole to the freaking. Let's give her a second. We're on her time. Okay, we're good. We're gonna talk about the post-show diet today, okay? This is a very, very asked about topic. You know, a lot of people have been asking, you know, what's your reverse looking like? What's your post-show diet looking like? And I'm gonna break this down into what I call the post-show recovery diet, right? You always think reverse, right? Reverse. And that's exactly what I use for a lot of clients, you know? I mean, the majority of clients that enter the program, I'm gonna implement reverses, because essentially what a reverse diet's gonna do is help you speed up your metabolism very, very well with putting on literally minimal, if not like any fat gain whatsoever throughout the process. This Jerry's hair is literally flying everywhere in front of me right now. So I'm gonna talk about two different ways to kind of approach coming out of a dieting phase, specifically a prep today. Obviously I just ended a prep, but the same applies to a lifestyle diet, right? I want you to be able to learn from this video and see what approach is gonna work best for you. Now, to break down a reverse diet, essentially, you're picking basically right off to where you left off and slowly adding carbs and fats week by week by week. Now, the last thing you want to do is pick off where you were digging, right? When I was digging, I got down to 100 grams of carbs. That is not where I'm going to pick it up and start dieting, right? And start reversing, because essentially, I'm picking that up and I'm dieting again. You know, the dieting's over. The show's over. Why continue dieting, right? You need to understand the physiological and the psychological symptoms of dieting, and you need to ask yourself how much longer you want to feel those symptoms, right? Which is why I actually recommend what I call a little bit more of a recovery diet protocol that still uses the same methods as a reverse, but you're actually going to be starting the reverse a little bit higher than what you think you're going to start that at. So the physiological symptoms that you're going to see from a diet or a long-term diet or a prep, for example, more specifically a prep, right? If you're lifestyle dieting and you're feeling these physiological changes, there's a chance that you probably need to put yourself into reverse or a diet break, right? But number one is gonna be the hormonal changes that you get from a prep, right? Essentially, when you get yourself to this single digit level of body fat percentage, you're going to see hormonal changes, specifically with leptin and ghrelin. Leptin is going to be the satiation hormone. This is the hormone that tells your body and tells your brain that you're full, right? Now, that is going to be extremely depleted the further along you get into dieting, right? Extremely depleted. You're gonna feel constantly hungry all the time. You're really never ever gonna feel that really, that sensation that you get when you're like completely full, right? Uncomfortable. That you don't get that when you get down to that level of dieting. Now, ghrelin is the hunger hormone, right? This is what sends signals to your brain that you're hungry. So ghrelin's gonna be high, leptin's gonna be low, and essentially no matter what you eat, you're always gonna feel hungry, right? That's just gonna throw off your hormones quite a bit here, right? Women are gonna go, you know, months without having their period. Men, your testosterone is gonna be pretty much depleted, pretty much to the freaking ground, which is essentially going to have negative effects on your sleep and also negative effects on your TDEE, which is your total daily energy expenditure, right? When you get yourself to a low body fat percentage, when you lose all this weight, your total daily energy expenditure is gonna go low, right? Your body just wants to just lay down and be a vegetable, and I fell victim to that, right? My step count dropped low, and your body stops burning a lot of calories. The reason being is because when you diet for a long amount of time, your metabolism starts to slow down over time, right? That's just what's gonna happen. There's no fighting that. Your metabolism is going to slow down, which means your body is gonna start burning less and less calories. So one thing that I do recommend as you're dieting is just get your step count up, right? If you're someone that works at a desk all day like me, something I started implementing is just 10 to 15 minute post-meal walks, right? This is essentially putting me around 6 to 10K steps a day. You know, nothing crazy, but it's getting my activity level up rather than just laying down. This also helps a lot with digestion, right? Getting your energy up to allow you to actually metabolize your food rather than just let it sit there, right? If you eat a big meal, for example, high volume meal, and you just lay down, chances are, you know, you're probably gonna bloat up, right? Chances are you're not moving around enough, which is going to inherently affect your digestion in a negative way. And last but not least, physiological symptoms you're gonna see is loss in strength, right? Now, I did my absolute best to not lose a single ounce of strength. I definitely did lose strength, but I was just fighting my absolute hardest to not lose any, right? I would say about 9 out of 10 people that go into a prep are gonna lose a significant amount of strength. That's just the way it's gonna be, right? So that is the last physiological, and honestly the most important, right? Symptom that you see from prep. Now moving to the psychological side of things here is the food focus, right? You're so focused on food all the time. What am I gonna eat next? Oh, when can I eat next? So what can I fit into my diet, right? Now when you get so food focused, especially coming out of a prep, right, you don't have that end goal. You don't have that step on stage moment that you're working towards anymore. You know, you end the prep and it's like, all right, well, it's off season, but you kind of feel this sense of freedom and this lack of accountability in a sense, to where if you're so food focused all the time, just like you were in prep, without an end goal, what do you think is gonna happen? Binge episodes, temporary, you know, eating disorders. This is a very common thing with competitors. This is a very common thing with people that spend a lot of time dieting in general, my friends, right? That post-show binge, you know, I told everyone, including myself, allow 48 hours, eat whatever you want, back on your shit. But some people can't get back on their shit because they're so food focused. And again, their ghrelin is super high and their leptin is super low. They just want to keep eating and eating and eating. That's where you need to be careful. One thing is also irritability, right? This is a thing amongst, you know, especially prep, but you'll notice this as you get deeper into dieting. Like when you put yourself under constant stress, going to the gym, cardio, and you're in a deficit, you are literally going to put yourself under like 3 to 5 times more stress than you normally are. That's just the truth, right? So irritability, you know, hangriness, that's all gonna come into play from a psychological standpoint. So when we talk the recovery diet, when you talk the post-show diet, all right, essentially you're gonna allow yourself about 4 to 8 weeks. I think this is a prime kind of time to really lock in on what a recovery diet is going to look like here. And essentially you should be okay with adding about anywhere from about 3 to 10% more body weight based off what your show day weight was, right? 10% may seem like a lot. So if you were, you know, if you got down to 164 stage, right, that 3 to 5% range could look like 165 to 168. That 10% range could be pushing to like 175, 176, right? Allowing yourself to gain that much weight over a 4 to 8 week period is gonna be absolutely necessary. Because guys, I think a lot of people like to think, oh, you know, like I stepped on stage at 175, let's see how long I can stay at 175. You think I'm gonna be happy staying at 175 after the show? No, because I'm gonna feel those symptoms of prep that I just talked about. And you need to actually allow yourself to dissipate those symptoms. How long do you wanna be feeling like shit? How long do you wanna be feeling fragile? Right, the number one physiological symptom is loss in strength. And what's gonna be the driving force of your progress, my friends? Training, performance. You need to put yourself in a position to be able to perform, to be able to get stronger, because guess what's gonna be the byproduct of getting stronger? Muscle gain, right? You are in a prime position coming out of a diet to put on a lot of lean mass in a short amount of time, being that 4 to 8 week period. And you want to actually put yourself in a position to be okay with a little bit of water retention, be okay with a little bit of body fat, because that is needed to help you perform. The workout that you saw today, I would not have been able to do that fucking workout eating 100 grams of carbs at the lowest point of prep. Absolutely not. But the reason why I felt great, I felt strong, I felt fluid, I didn't feel fragile, I felt full the whole time is because, you know, I'm up about 4.5 pounds, right? And I'm okay with that. right? I'm okay with that. And over the next 48 weeks, I'm gonna slowly start adding in more food, but it's gonna come down to adherence. And I'll tell you what, it's gonna be a lot easier to adhere to a higher amount of calories than to adhere to where you're picking up at the lowest point of your prep. To pick up, this is the big question. Okay, what should I be doing with my macros? Jerry, why don't you tell them, dude? What should they be doing with their macros? What Jerry essentially said is that you should not be picking it up again where you left off in your digging phase, but you should look at your stage weight, minus 175, and pick up around where that maintenance would be around that stage weight, right? Now, again, you need to keep in mind that your TDEE, your total daily expenditure, is low. Your metabolism is slow when you get down to that body fat percentage, right? So essentially, you know, you have your scale of activity level here. You know, your body weight times 14 if you're not so active. That's where you kind of want to, times 15 if you're moderately active, times 16 if you're super active, fast-ass metabolism. Guys, your metabolism's slow. You want to take your stage weight, you want to times it by about 14, and you want to either, you know, start off there or subtract about 250 calories from that point and have that be the starting point of your recovery and reverse diet. Now, this is where adherence comes into play, right? You know, a lot of people are gonna feel, you're still gonna feel that physiological effect of the hormone imbalances, right? You're gonna feel hungry all the time. You know, you don't have that end goal anymore. You don't have that stage goal. So the first thing that's kind of in your mind is also the psychological piece of being food focused, right? Oh, what can I eat next, right? And that's gonna give you the temptations of going into your pantry, grabbing those snacks, not tracking them, letting that compound, and then in your head, you're just like, okay, you know, it's okay, like, I don't have a show anymore, I don't have to be as consistent anymore, I don't have to track to a T anymore, I can keep, you know, snacking, and, you know, that's where you lead to your episodes, right? So you wanna be away from there, but you wanna allow yourself for your libido, your testosterone, your hormones to start regulating again, right? And again, you're not gonna allow yourself to feel that and overcome those symptoms and feel that high level of energy and feel like a freaking human again if you pick up at 100 damn grams of carbs. So moral of the story is, guys, be okay with a little bit of water retention, be okay with a little bit of body fat, just knowing this is necessary, right? Now, this isn't giving you an excuse to, you know, go up 15 pounds, 10 pounds post show, right? In reality, guys, be okay with, again, 5 to 10% body weight added onto that stage weight over a period of 4 to 8 weeks, okay? So that doesn't mean 10% of your body weight gets added on in 1 week, right? So start off around, you know, take that last month of prep, for example, or right around where you start before your digging phase, right? So for me, before I went into my digging phase of 120, 100 carb, I was at 200 carbs. So that's where I decided to pick up, right? And now from here, it's gonna be all based off feel. Right now, I feel great. You know, I can eat 200 carbs for this next 1-2 weeks and feel great because I had a full weekend of great eating. My energy's high, you know, I'm full. And essentially from there, it's a matter of fact of looking at where your body weight is and measuring your performance. Are you feeling stronger session by session? Are you feeling good in the gym? If you're still feeling like shit, adhere to your macros and add in some more carbs next week. And over time, my friends, you want to start adding in those carbs slowly. And what I recommend is just about 100 calories worth. So that's about 25 grams of carbs per week moving forward. 25, 50 grams of carbs per week moving forward. Obviously, you want to be able to take a look at your metrics and see, oh, hey, if I add 25 grams of carbs, you're not going to be in a position to where you're gaining a bunch of body fat when you keep it to 100, 150 calories, 200 calories added on per week, right? You're gonna start seeing the process of a reverse diet, which you're just gonna speed up your metabolism here over time, right? And, you know, coming out of a dieting phase, coming out of, you know, anything, and if you guys have seen my body recomposition video, right, you need to put yourself in a position to have a very fast metabolism in order for you to perform well, in order for you to gain lean muscle, in order for you to minimize fat gain, right? So it's gonna come down to adherence. Don't eat like an asshole, but at the same time, don't start your reverse off too low and don't go too slow. Again, 4 to 8 weeks, allow yourself 5 to 10% over your body weight, and you guys are gonna be good to go. Last but not least, my friends, I always recommend that there's intention behind your training and nutrition, right? When you guys have this show date, the show day, you get so locked in and so focused and so accountable that you never want to miss a step. You never want to miss a macro, right? Now, essentially for me, the reason why I'm going to adhere to this reverse super well is because I know, one, I got to be shredded for Cancun. And two, I want to take advantage of this off season as best as I possibly can. I want to maximize the amount of lean muscle that I'm going to put on and stay lean. I don't want to blow up like a freaking water balloon and look like the Michelin man a month later, right? So that's all the motivation I need. But you guys need to have a driving force and a motivator to give you intention, right? If it's a future, if you want to step on stage in the future, you had to hold yourself accountable to regimenting your shit right now. Right, you need to have an end goal to push towards. And in reality, guys, I was plus or minus 1 to 2 grams per macro for this entire prep. Right, moving into this reverse, I'm gonna be plus or minus 5 to 10 grams and be okay with that. Right, as I get later and deeper into my off season, I can be plus or minus 10 to 20 grams and be okay with that. Right, and then essentially, guys, what makes it part of your lifestyle is taking what you learn from tracking your own macros, weighing out your own foods, and then honestly, if you want to take a little break, but it's hard to just track your macros within 1 freaking gram 365 days out of the year, be okay with being able to just track protein and calories, or be okay with just tracking calories. But you will not be in a position to learn how to track protein and calories, learn how to track calories only, if you haven't spent time actually learning how to track your macros and getting very good out of that, right? Practice makes perfect. At the end of the day, the more you practice tracking your macros, the more adherent, the more knowledgeable, and the more mindful you're gonna be when it comes to your nutrition. So I hope this video helped out. Go ahead and leave a like down below. Go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'm just here to make sure that you guys don't get fat as shit coming out of your goddamn shows, all right? Peace out, and I'll see you in the next video. It's a no problem. No problem. Ha 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 ha.